It's not on the coaches. It's on the players. It's on me. We got to execute better. And we got to finish. We got to finish because we have them. We just got to finish.
It's the second, the Navy, not the same exact circumstances, but you guys felt like this after the Navy loss too. Can you even, can you compare the feeling after those two?
I feel like it's worse. It's worse now simply because the standards of this game. I mean, it was an ESPN game, a top ranked 25 team, you know. So this one hurts a lot worse simply because we, I'm lost for words, honestly. But this one hurts a lot worse than the Navy. Yeah, we just let it slip through our fingers. So like I said, we got to stay together. That's going to be the main thing, is staying together as a team and preparing for Memphis to finish this season strong.
Was it difficult to go against a quarterback that you had not prepared for at all, and did that affect anything?
There was a gray area simply because, you know, when you knock the first string quarterback out, then you knock the second string quarterback out. A lot of times, you know, you don't know, you're not prepared for, you know, the third string quarterback. But I still feel like it comes back to us in execution. No matter who they put at quarterback, they could have put the cornerback there. We got to play our type of football. Got to play our type of defense, play our style.
What was your view on the play at the end of regulation, the touchdown pass?
A wide spread drop back, corner ran a drag route from the three. And when we left Pratt hands on, I thought it was a touchdown. I actually closed my eyes. I thought it was a touchdown. You know, I'm getting ready to go back on defense. And then you see 23 running down the sideline. But like I said, you know, if they don't score, they don't win the game. So defensively, you know, me and, you know, the defense, we take responsibility. Because they don't score, they don't win. You know, offense did the best they could. Kudos to them. Defensively, we got to execute better. That was the third string quarterback. Not downplaying him by any means because he was very talented. Very talented. But we got to play better. We got to execute better.
Steph, can you just put into words what the feeling is like in a game where it looked like you had it in the bag there in the fourth quarter?
Unbelievable, man. We still have yet to play a full game. We're getting tired of these almost games. You know, we got to stop having almost games. We got to come together as a team and finish strong. We didn't finish right there.
It was 14-0 in the fourth quarter. You guys were driving. You got a penalty that knocked you back. Was there ever a moment where you could sense the momentum changing?
No. We just told the guys, you know, wave can't beat the wave. You know, that's a little saying we have. We just know that we can't put ourselves in situations to where we're playing behind the chains. So, I mean, we kept cool heads and just moved along with it.
Stephon, how difficult is that to, like, mentally move on once you get to overtime? Like, after that Hail Mary throw, just to kind of try and reset. I mean, just how difficult is that from y'all's standpoint, did you feel like?
See that play? Just gotta see right there. We in position. Like, we had guys around the ball. We just didn't make a play right there. So I mean, moving on, we just those situations that we gotta work more in practice. We just gotta want it more. Actually, the play is there for us to make. We're in position to make the play. We just gotta finish it. But moving on is tough, but that's gonna make us better as a team. Knowing what we gotta fix.
The offense had a chance to end it on its first possession of overtime with a touchdown. How disappointing was it to have to keep playing on when it was in the offense's hands there?
I would have said it's tough, but I wouldn't say it's disappointing because knowing Merrick comes up big for us. So we know if if we got some points on the board, if we got a field goal on the board, we're going to be able to get back on the field and try again. So, I mean, a lot of pressure right there. But then again, we knew that we was about to come back on the field and we had to score again.
What was your view on the final play?
What was my view on the final play? We just almost, man. We just got a finish right there. We're in position. The finish is right there in the eyes. We got a finish. That's it. That's all I can say.
You guys did a pretty good job of bouncing back from the Navy loss. How do you, you've got one game left in the regular season. How do you, what do you say to guys? How do you get back from this one?
Just know that we just get back in the film room and we watch film tomorrow and we fix those things like we did against Navy. We come together as a team and just, we put all the mistakes out there on the table for everybody to see and things that we can and cannot do. And that's how we get better as a team, just knowing and learning from our mistakes from last game.
Devon, is it important to, and maybe you guys already kind of chatted to him after the game, but to chat with Michael Pratt? I mean, I know I feel like he had a pretty good game outside of the one throw, but you kind of say anything after the game to kind of console him, if that's the right way to put it?
Yeah, see, with Pratt, he's probably thinking the game's on him right now. So with us, where our job is, my job especially, because I've taken him a lead on his team, to just keep him going and tell him that the reason he lost his game is not his fault. You know what I'm saying? We had plenty of plays that could have been made before that play happened. You know, like we should probably shouldn't have gotten to that point right there. But my job as a lead on his team is to keep Pratt going, keep his head up.